It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1594, recorded Thursday, October 27th, 2016. Small price, big disappointment. This episode of the Giz Wiz, it is the end of my driving crappy theme month. Dick has three gadgets and a warehouse video, and we have a what the heck is it from Douglas. All next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz. Play that chicken theme. No. me and Dickie D are dressed very similarly on this
coordinated
Giz Wiz. I guess we both like red plaid shirts.
Yeah. Well, it's getting to be winter here, wintery here. So that's my excuse.
Yeah, you know, it's pretty wintry. Well, no, it's not. Not in Texas. I don't think there's much winter to be had here. But.
Oh, so tell me. So you are raising funds. Tell us.
Yes. So, Minecraft, I went to the Minecraft Marathon, and let me see if I can get the exact number here. Crackmarathon.com, and we raised tons and tons and tons of money for the Children's Miracle Network of Hospitals. Dang it, our website isn't live. It just is showing photos that happened during the event. We had so much fun. We raised a lot of money. I believe it was $175K, something like that.
What?
Let me see if I can find it.
Holy cow!
Yeah, it was. We did it in partnership with Microsoft, with forgetting all the names. It's like I remember them this weekend, and then they all just went away. Pixel Core, we did, just tons and tons of fun. Extra Life, Mindcrack, let me see.
Yeah. Pixel Core is Alex Lindsay, right?
Exactly.
Yeah,
ran all of the tech behind the scenes, which really made me
great.
Feel fantastic. Here we are. We raised $167,486, which was just incredible to do. We had over 48 hours of content, and it was just a blast. And I mean, nothing really comes
close.
So
you were awake for all 48 hours, or did you take shifts?
We took shifts. We had a few people who were awake all 48 hours. Sevetis was the one that jumps to mind, and he was our basically run of show manager, and he'd make sure everybody was doing everything they needed to do. I was lucky enough to have to take to be able to take some shifts. I got about 7 hours of sleep one night, which was fantastic, and about hours of sleep the next night, which was good as well. It was just we had all these different segments. We had these gaming segments where people could donate and affect how the game was being played, where they could donate in-game items and they would just show up in your inventory so you could use them to fight in battles. We did what we called Sliced, which was a cooking competition where one cook was sliced after every competition. And the winner of that, we didn't really have any prizes or anything. It was just a ton of fun. We did what we called Battleship Twister, which is where you get two twister boards and a divider. And there's specific rules about how you can put your hands in, and you can never just step off of the playing mat. So let's say, you know, you put four hands down.
Oh, yeah, okay, right.
you decide on them, and they stay there. And then you would call out, say, red six. And it's like, oh, well, if that's a hit, you have to take up whatever hand or foot that was. But you could never leave So, and you can never put your hand back down on the ground. So if you had a hand and a foot missing, you had to make sure that you were balancing. And if you were completely out, you had to lean on your other teammates. So at one point, there was someone who was completely out, and he was sitting on my back as I had one hand and one foot, and we were both trying to balance. It was just a ton of fun, Battleship Twister.
That was sponsored by the Chiropractic Institute.
Yeah, Association of America. Yeah, exactly.
Yes, yeah, right. Exactly.
Right. It was just so much fun. And of course, we ended up donating over $167,000 to the Children's Miracle Network of Hospitals, which, of course, in its own right, was fantastic. So,
I think that's super.
Yeah, it was a great time. It was a really, really, really great time. It was not comfortable, Bleak. He says, sounds comfortable. But it was a lot of fun, and a lot of people had a great time watching as well. So, yeah, I was down in San Francisco this weekend to do that. Came back on Monday. And now I'm back for a long time, it feels like, finally.
Yeah, at least 3 weeks, I think, we're going to be a normal time. So.
Right. Right?
Yeah.
Right. Woohoo.
All right.
That's what I did over the weekend.
Should we do it?
Let's jump into the show.
Okay, so last week I said I was done with bike gadgets, but I was looking through the videos, and I forgot. This was, I think, my favorite thing from Interbike. It is so clever. So we'll watch the final video here. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Madness Rider, and the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. Montague bikes, great folding bikes, but we're here with David Montague because this caught my eye. It is a bike rack with a big difference, and David is going to demo it and tell us about it.
Sure. Well, it's basically in this position, you can see it is a luggage carrier, so you put your luggage on here. In addition, it is also a fender. You can see the fender through here, so that stops the rain and mud from getting on you when you're riding. And then there's a little latch right here. You just unlatch the latch, and it is a kickstand in this position. And finally, if you want to work on your drivetrain of your bike, it's a work stand in this position. So it's four things in one.
Four things in one.
This is really great.
And the price
before.
Is?
It's under $100 for retail.
Under $100. Montague Bikes, and it's called Rack Stand. I like this a lot. Dickie Bartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv at Interbike.
How was this not invented before? This is
I know. Is that not clever?
It's super clever, super useful, inexpensive.
Yes. So you have the luggage rack. The luggage rack has its own built-in fender because most of those bikes don't have fenders in the back. So if you ride through mud and water, it throws it up. But then you unhook it and slide it down, and it's a bike stand.
Why don't all bikes? This should have been the default thing that all bikes have. Who uses that stupid kickstand that gets caught in everything?
Yes.
It doesn't really keep your bike from falling over in most situations. You have to lean it at an angle so it takes up more room. This is great.
It's very clever. So right now, they're shipping it on some of their own bikes, Montague bikes. If you have a Montague folding bike, when you fold it up, it actually stands on that stand, and they're making it available as an accessory, and they said it will fit most 26-inch or 27.5-inch bike wheels. So very, very clever. You know, when you said a bike stand, there was one company there. The guy didn't even have any literature, but it was a kickstand that doubled as a bicycle pump. So I thought, well, that's a clever idea because, you know, the pump is pretty much a straight line, but the guy had no literature on it. And so I'll keep my eye out for when that comes along. But I love when you get two-in-one things where both parts of it are really useful.
Yeah. And really, this seems, you know, how quickly it you know, flipped down and how sturdy the stand seemed to be. I'm so surprised that 30 years ago this wasn't invented and became the norm on all bikes. This is so smart.
Yes,
so smart. And there's no final price yet, right?
It's going to be $100, about $100.
Around $100. Okay.
It's built into their own bikes, but as I said, on their website, it just has info about it, but not availability yet as an accessory. But the fact that it fits 26 and 27 and a half inch wheels bodes well for a lot of bike owners who might want to buy this and add it to their own bike.
Interesting. Wow. Yeah. Okay, the Rack Stand by Montague.
Rack Stand, yeah. And somewhere in the future, I'm still waiting for this company. They had an LED bike for kids.
Wow.
So when I said, LED bike, I need to know about this. So far, I've not gotten the info, but when I do, I'll throw that in as another gadget.
Sounds good.
Yeah. In the meantime, something new from Logitech. We spoke for about 1 minute before the show. You knew that this was out.
Yes.
I'm actually using it. So for, like 4 or 5 years now, the last Logitech camera out was the C920.
Yes.
And I think over at Twitter, I think they ask people or send people a C920,
right?
If they don't have a, as the default camera for casual broadcasters. Well, now Logitech has introduced the C922 Pro Streaming webcam. Now, this does 1080p. I'm using it in 1080p. 1080p at 30 frames a second. But it also has another setting for 720p at 60 frames a second. So now you as a gamer, that's important, right?
To be able to. Exactly. Many live streamers will stream at 60 frames a second because what they're most likely streaming is video games. And video games can stream at 60. And there's a big difference. You can really tell the fluidity of the camera, of the stream at 60 frames. And I got to be honest, I'm very, very, very excited about a new webcam because as a content creator who uses webcams, this entire show is run off of webcams. This is actually a webcam that we're looking at right now. I've been very, very, very frustrated in the past with how webcams seem to break all the time, how many times their drivers seem super old and not updated. And having a new webcam is so exciting. And there's been basically two new webcams that have come out that I'm looking forward to. Logitech C922. By the way, full disclosure, my mother works for a company that is owned by Logitech. But the C922 and then also Razer has a webcam that I'm very excited about that I haven't gotten a chance to play with.
Right.
Go ahead.
No, I was going to say, this one is replacing the C920 at the same price, $99.99. And this one comes with, I'm going to look at the name of the software.
XSplit.
It comes with this green screen replacement software where, I forgot what I'm looking for. It's a funny name. Oh, Personify. Okay.
Right.
So Personify software is a way to do a fake green screen. And I actually tried it. So it's a little tricky. You have to kind of sit still. They recommend you be very well lighted and that you sort of have one neutral color behind you. And then it can pop you out so you can super yourself over the game you're playing. If you satisfy those things where you're kind of still well lit and there's not a busy background. Otherwise, it gets very confused as to what your head is. Some people reported that it cut their ears off because it didn't recognize.
Right.
It thought headphones were part of the background. And I have so much junk in my background. I mean, you could see just about an outline of me, but it didn't know exactly what to do. But that software is free. And there is a bonus that comes with the C922. And it comes two different ways. If you buy the 922 on Amazon, you'll be shipped the 922X. The camera is the same. The only thing is the packaging. The 922X gives you 6 months of XSplit service for free. And normally that's, I actually buy it by the year, but I think it's about $5 a month. Do you use that?
I've switched to OBS, but it is a very similar product. It's a live streaming service, and they make theirs more of a service than just like a software.
Yeah, exactly. So you get 3 months free. You get 6 months free on Amazon. If you go to Best Buy, let me reach over here. If you go to Best Buy, you get this little tripod, which, by the way, sells for about $8 on Amazon, and 3 months of XSplit.
Do you know why they do this?
No.
You're going to be so mad when you find out.
Oh, no. Why? Go ahead.
They do this because now Amazon and Best Buy cannot price match each other because they're two different types of products. Because the one that's sold on Amazon is the C922X, and the one sold in Best Buy is the C922 with a tripod. So you can't match the prices, so Best Buy will always have a Best Buy price, and Amazon will always have an Amazon price.
Amazing. You see, and you just thought watching the Giz Wiz was
a waste of time. Yeah.
Yeah, wait a second. Let me just look. This is our 78th independent content show and your first piece of valuable information.
I know. You know, it only took 78 until you were blown away.
Yeah. Right. Wow. Inside stuff. So anyway, now you explain the difference. But I do like the XSplit software, and I like the camera. And you were going to say something. I interrupted you. I'm sorry about that.
No. The only thing that I think I was going to mention was – so I remember the other webcam that I was excited about, Stargazer from Razer. And that does the same background replacement technology, but it uses Intel's RealSense technology, which requires another camera. So if you look, I have the Stargazer up on my computer.
You can
see that there's multiple cameras in this so that it can do that replacement.
Oh, you mean the two cameras are in the one camera?
Exactly. So this is one webcam. This bar is one webcam. And it has an infrared camera. I think it has an infrared blaster, an infrared camera to pick up the blaster, and the normal webcam. And I'm not exactly sure. I'm not an engineer on this, but that it also streams at 60 frames at 720. So this is the Intel RealSense, which will replace you in the background. I believe, based off of a CNET article that I read this, and this is why I believe that the Logitech camera doesn't use any of that. It doesn't use a RealSense. It uses basically object recognition to tell that this is your head and uses software to process your head out instead of using inputs like infrared sensors and things like that.
But that camera is it 150 or 200?
Yeah, it's pretty expensive. Let me hit buy now and find out how much it costs.
Okay.
And the Razer Stargazer is $150. Right, so $50 more money.
$50 more. Okay. So if you need that for sure, then the Razer is, or
to be honest,
just sit still and save $50.
Exactly, and or just get a green screen. Maybe you could buy a green screen for $50, and I think you're going to have a better result with it because a lot of the consumer green screen that's built into XSplit or into OBS is pretty okay nowadays. They've actually done a fairly good job recently with that, and I've used the Stargazer in a convention setting where it was a convention hall, and I did not like the results. If you held up your hand, it was very wiggly and wavy around the edge.
This was the
consumer product. This wasn't like before it was shipped or anything like that. So,
all right, and this one has twin mics, but again. Right. Any external mic is going to be better than what's built into you. I mean, the webcam's going to have better mics than what's built in your computer.
Right.
But for any kind of broadcasting, you're going to want a standalone mic.
So this is the newest webcam since 2012. 2012 was the last time that Logitech released.
Amazing. it is amazing. And it was funny because they were at PepCom or something, and I said, why have you guys not come out with a new webcam in like 5 years?
Right.
And they said, hang on. What do you have, ESP? We just did. So.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, so I'm excited because I think I'm going to upgrade all my cameras away from these four-year-old cameras that I use. Here's the current one that I use right here. This is the product camera that I use.
Oh, okay.
All of them are the C920s. So I'm excited to upgrade to new cameras in the studio, and hopefully it'll work great with the software that I use too. So
excellent. Exciting. Excellent. Very good. All right, and then finally, we're going on to something called Tech Week in New York City. And Tech Week is a week of lectures and classes where people learn how to, if they have an invention, what to do with it. And one of those days at Tech Week is an exhibit day where people show products that they are trying to market or get into the marketplace. So I found one product that's very interesting. I wish this person a lot of luck. So let's take a look at something that is called Refill. So that's Tech Week. And as I said, there are all these lectures and speakers, but I just wanted to go to the event where you could see what people were pitching as products. So I found three. Two of them I'm just going to mention because they're kind of bizarre. The one I thought has a good shot is a product called Refill, and they have a little animated film to show you exactly what Refill is, and so we can look at that and then talk about it.
Americans use 2 million single-use plastic bottles every 5 minutes. Yet the bottled water life cycle is extremely wasteful, and most bottled water comes right from the tap. The bottling process wastes a lot of water. And energy is wasted manufacturing and transporting the water. Although single-use bottles are potentially recyclable, most end up in the landfill or the ocean.
Refill provides a network of stations where members can fill bottles with cold, filtered tap water. The stations are conveniently located in local businesses like coffee shops and juice bars, and the dense network means a refill station is never more than 2 blocks away. Using the Refill app, members locate the nearest station, activate it with their phone's Bluetooth, and instantly access cold, filtered water. Consumers are waiting for this solution. Students and governments across the nation are banning the bottle. Now the university student can refill when meeting friends off campus, the parent can refill while shuttling kids around town, the urban professional can refill on the way to the bar after work, and the commuter can refill on the way to the office. With just 100,000 subscribers in one city, millions of single-use water bottles are saved from the landfills and from our oceans each year.
As Refill expands to new users and new cities and provides options in place of other bottled beverages, we can work toward the ultimate goal of making all single-serve plastic bottles obsolete.
Okay, hey. So that was very clever. So the gentleman who created this is an alumni of NYU, and I believe the money was funded by the NYU Green Projects, Green Grants Projects. So they have 9 water stations within a few blocks of NYU, and the deal is, hopefully, when they get this up and running in a bigger area, you pay $1.98 a monthly fee, and then it's an app. You bring up the app, and it'll show you where the nearest station is. And I asked the guy, I said, well, why would like a coffee shop even bother putting in one of these devices? And he said that walk-in traffic is a very big thing with stores, that to get people to just go into a store is something that they really desire, and that they feel that by putting this into a store, and that they know, at least beginning, a lot of students are going to go in to fill their bottles. While they're there, they might buy whatever else they're selling, coffee or Danish or sandwiches or whatever. So I think this does have a possibility, but I don't know.
I mean, definitely if these were absolutely everywhere, that would be interesting. I think my hope is that places of business would just offer cold filtered water for you.
Oh, okay.
You know, no, I like it. But it also, it, like, the next step in my head is they should just sell the device that filters and chills the water for the place of business to walk in.
Oh, that's a good idea.
You know, like, just feel like the next step is okay, maybe Refill's just the brand of filter that anyone can just buy and is a product that you could install into a wall or install on a countertop.
No, that's not a bad idea. And then that way you would do it for like 50 cents because you bring the bottle in. The person would get fresh, chilled, filtered water, and no bottle will have been thrown out.
Right.
So that's actually a good idea.
Interesting.
That's actually a good idea.
Yeah, and also it's just kind of – it would feel so weird if there is this nice water stand. Okay, someone comes in, I'm dying of thirst. Can I have a water?
Sorry,
sir, but you have to pay $2 a month to get access to that water. I guess they could go into the back and fill you up something, but I don't know.
No, okay.
I'm worried. Okay. I really like the idea, and I think, obviously getting rid of a single-use bottles, great mission. I just feel like this is one of those things that's like...
Go to the next one. And we can... I forgot which one. Whatever comes up, we can talk about.
Okay.
This is another one that was at the show, and this is. All right. So this is good. Workout as if you were do a prison workout.
Okay. Let's watch this video.
Okay. So. Now.
We grew up two blocks away from here, and back in the day, all you hear is these sirens, drug lines actually coming up this building. We lived under the poverty line. My mom didn't have much. She worked in a factory. People would ask me, what do you want to do when you grow up? And I told them I want to be rich. The first opportunity that I had to become rich was through the world of drugs. I started at 11 smoking weed, getting involved heavily with coke and crack, and I started selling crack right on this block. Grew it out to a multi-million-dollar company. At the age of 19, I was making over $2 million a year. 23, I was charged with one of the largest drug delivery services in New York City, charged as a kingpin. I went into prison. The doctors told me that cholesterol levels were so bad that I could have died within 5 years. I was sentenced to 7 years in prison, and I said I was not gonna die in prison. I started doing push-ups, dips with the limited space that I had and began moving. Lost 70 pounds in 6 months. I caught the eyes from other inmates, helped over 20 inmates lose over 1,000 pounds combined. And I came up with the idea while I was in solitary confinement, and I wanted to create something special and different. So I came up with ComBody. Today, we hire formerly incarcerated individuals. I felt the same pain coming home. I couldn't find a job. Everybody was shutting the door behind me because of my record. Giving them an opportunity and a second chance. Started ComBody. And now it's taken off. I want to help as many formerly incarcerated people as possible and give them a second chance. So sign up and join us. Come do the time. Peace.
Okay, so ComBody. Okay. So have the body of a convict, basically. No, sorry.
Well, no. So, I mean, it's a fascinating idea. Here's a guy who already had a couple million dollars. But now you can stream the lessons in your own home. I forgot how much he charges. But the object here is train like a con.
Right. I just love this story that someone who had a bad lot in life came up with a great idea and is now making money and helping other people. It's really hard if you have a conviction to get a job.
No, absolutely. Absolutely. But yet we still employ you, Chad. It's your background. No matter what happened. Right.
I'm trying to find their prices. It doesn't seem very simple to see here. I'm looking for how much it cost. I thought this said price. It says press.
Oh, okay. No, I thought I sign up for free. Yeah. You know, I thought it was $5 a lesson or something, but I don't know. I don't know. No, I just picked it out because I thought, boy, this is really an interesting idea, is for someone to say, you know, normally you hear stories about, so they go to the library every single day, the thing, and they come out and they're a lawyer. But here's somebody who actually was helping other people in prison and then came out and then started a business. Right. So I think that's very...
It's $5 a month, free for 30 days.
Boy, yeah. $5 a month is
only $5 a month, yeah.
Oh, okay.
To stream workouts, and that seems great. Workout from anywhere, get a second chance. Yeah, wow. Interesting. Yeah.
Okay.
I assume all workouts are done remotely?
I thought it was that you stream them and just do them in your home. Maybe also you can pay money and go to the place, but I believe he only has one location.
That's
right now.
That's interesting. But, you know. I would love to see a little bit more about how that works, because also if it was something like a live video situation, they could say, no, lower your hips, raise your elbows a little higher and things like that without someone being there, and you just stay at home and do it. That seems...
That would be interesting, actually, is to have like Skype where the guy you pay $30 and he watches you at in your own home and corrects you.
Wow.
Yeah.
So it says, what happens if I can't work out at the time the video goes live? Well, you could download it and watch it later. And it's also interesting because if you're doing a workout in the confinement of a cell, well, I hope that my house has enough room as a prison cell. And so I don't need a whole gym space, an entire area dedicated to a home gym. I just need a room that has enough room to walk around and do some dips and things like that. That's great. Each session is between 20 and 30 minutes. This actually seems really cool. Interesting.
Yeah.
I love it.
Our final one is, I don't see how this could ever work. It's called Drone Go Home. And Drone Go Home is... when I was talking to the woman there, they hadn't worked out a lot of things, is how to actually stop drones from flying over your business. And the one thing I saw on their website that I thought was, God, I didn't even think about that, is drones flying over prisons.
Right.
Where they could drop stuff in.
Right.
So I said, well, if I own the business, how would you protect me? And she said, well, she didn't really have a great...
We don't know yet.
We don't know
yet.
There's
no laws for any of
this. Exactly. They're waiting to see what the FAA is going to say about drones. But it is that was the biggest problem I thought is, well, a drone over a prison is tricky. You could drop...
Their website, The Challenge... Okay, click that. The challenge. Oh, paragraphs of text. The solution. Click that. Patent pending. We don't know.
We don't know.
We don't have the solution. Right. How it works.
I said, even though you don't know the solution, do you have an idea of what you would charge? And she said, as little as $1,000 a month. I'm going,
ooh.
What?
Interesting. Wow. I mean, this is a good point to bring up. It's interesting. There's already a company created that there could be, say, a wireless signal that all drones must adhere to, and if they fly within that signal, they have to leave that area.
Yes.
It seems like that's kind of what they're showing with the imagery on their site.
Exactly. So it's their saying that we will have a problem, we will have a solution once we know exactly what the problem is and what the government's going to be doing about it first, and then we'll jump in. But it was just sort of interesting, I thought.
Yeah, I think so too.
So far, we're going to sign you up for the convict thing. Okay, you're in for that.
I'm in for the convict
And you're
classes.
Getting no water. No water.
I have no tap water. Only single-use bottles for me, because I ex-nayed the $2 subscription fee. But I will sign up for the con class. So Drone Go Home seems like an interesting concept. I feel like it's almost like if you list a website on the internet, you can put in the root of your website robots.txt, and that's a signal to Google to not scrape your site, to not look at your site. Seems like there should be something like that in the drone space, that maybe there is I mean, there's all sorts of stuff. I can think of way back in the day at a public pool, the changing area was open to the sky. I would definitely not want drones flying over that changing area. That sort of thing would be that you could set up a beacon that says no drones fly over this space. So, interesting concept, still needs to find a solution, but good to know that it's out there.
Exactly. All right, so that finishes my stuff, and I assume we have no ad, right?
No ad.
No ad. So, ladies and gentlemen, that means only one possible thing. It's time for...
You know you don't need it, but you might want it. It's Crappy Corner. Get it.
So it is the end of driving month. I'm sad because there was a lot of good driving gadgets that I still feel are out there. And this week I wanted to get something that was a little family focused. This is an issue that many families have, is you have a family inside your minivan and it just gets completely trashed by kids. And so this is a clean solution for an inexpensive price. I went ahead and recorded a video of it in my car. So let's take it away, me from the past. Hey, Diggy D. So here we are in the car, and I have the portable vacuum from Car and Driver, the approved selections.
Ooh, and here it is.
Yeah. Ooh. So it comes with an attachment and some instructions, and of course the vacuum itself, which we will pull out of the bubble wrap. Ooh, so nice. So the attachment would go on the front, like so. There we go. Okay, cool. Let's get rid of the attachment and the box. And I assume I know how to use it. And let's plug it in into the power outlet. It works.
Whoa! Wow!
Okay, it works. Okay, so we have some honey nut toasted Cheerios here.
Oh, look at this. What a demo.
Put it in the car.
Throw a few of those in there.
Whoa.
Crush a few.
This is all out. Wow.
Got to get those crumbs in there. Now, let's see if the Car and Driver approved selections vacuum cleaner does the job. Seems to be working.
Yeah.
I'd say it does a pretty good job. Hey, look at that. I would say that is pretty darn clean. I didn't even need to use the attachment. Try to use the attachment. I would say that is a solid little vacuum cleaner. There's little, okay, and then let's see how do we undo it here. There we go. There's the filter. It doesn't look so.
What's that, a handkerchief?
How do I get this out of here? There we go. Pull the filter out. Of course, right on. Oh. What the heck is wrong with this filter?
What
looks
is
like
that?
It's a Frankenstein filter. Okay.
It's like they used some sort of plastic injection molding and
that?
It didn't inject correctly.
We can throw that away.
Oh.
That looks like it works, other than this really horrible looking filter. So I guess
Guess it works. It was a good buy for $10 at Ross. Dress for less. Back to the studio. So I think that it worked just fine. Now, of course, it doesn't. There's no way you could use this in your house because it only has the cigarette lighter attachment. So that's kind of a downside that it doesn't come with any adapter to plug into the wall. And then that filter that we were talking about earlier, something just looks wrong with it. Like something happened bad to it. You can kind of see that it was somehow injected, molded, and some of the plastic came through and some of it didn't.
Is it supposed to be a replaceable filter?
I think this is a smack it to clean it filter. I don't think this is replaceable. Okay. And then it has these two sort of sections. So it has you place the filter into that, then place that into here, and then place the vacuum on top of that. Now, on Amazon, it didn't get such great reviews. Unfortunately, there was only one, because this is a product that I found at Ross, which is a discount store here in the area. But, of course, there's many, many, many of these. There's only one-star review. It says, don't buy it because it didn't work at all. It suck big time, which is actually, you would think that the suction would a good thing, but anyway.
Yeah, but you know what? Car and Driver is like a famous name.
Right, exactly.
So I don't think they would lend their name to something that didn't work at all.
The Car and Driver approved selection of this. So we found it online for $12.50. I bought it off of Ross for $10, and it says that its comparable value is $26. It says that it is 60 watts and 60 watts, 12 volts. Sorry, I'm trying to show this to you here. And it comes with the attachment as well, with a slim nozzle attachment. Washable, bagless filter, a 9-foot cord, and a removable
dust. Oh, that filter's supposed to be washable?
Exactly. So you're supposed to run that underwater or turn that off. So,
okay.
So there
it looks like someone already ran it through the dishwasher.
It seems like somebody ran it through a weed whacker.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So
that's not bad, actually.
I think that it's okay. I think that it's a solid okay product for $9. And I just found this locally. The thing to do would be to ask the chat room to find a comparable product that anyone could buy online, because I bet that there is a small portable vacuum cleaner that people could use. But the Car and Driver Select vacuum cleaner, I wish I could turn it on, but of course it only plugs into the car.
And you don't have an AC to 12-volt adapter
house? Every once in a while I just think, what am I doing wrong with my life to not have the AC to 12 volt.
Yeah, see, I don't have a car, so I actually have an AC to 12 volt.
Oh, that's funny. Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. I guess a few people would need that, but yeah. So that is the Car and Driver Approved Selections vacuum cleaner. It's funny, I can actually sort of see the motor in the middle of this. You can't really see it. Barely in there. It's just a little itty-bitty motor that's used to vacuum things out. So that is the end of our crappy corner selections for this month. Of course, we're going to be asking our patrons very, very soon what the next month's theme should be. So take this moment as your opportunity to jump on over to patreon.com and support the show so that you can affect what next month's theme of crappy gadgets can be. And with that...
Yes.
Let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Fog a horn.
And we have no viewer video for this week, so let's look at something from my gadget warehouse.
DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Welcome to Dick's Country Store. Doesn't this look like, look at this. This goes back many years, back when I used to do consumer reports on television. The Country Store organizer, so this is like 25 years ago. It was only $5.95, and I'm just going to turn it toward me a little. Charming turn-of-the-century replicas are so practical. Organizing and sorting bills and mail, coupons, important papers. The top's ideal for displaying cosmetics, plants, the recessed shelves for odds and ends. The family drawer, the handy drawer is good for clips and jewelry. It's a handsome wood finish. I mean, how could they do that for $5.95? I mean, that's probably about $20 today. So let's get that little piece of furniture. And there is your Country Store organizer.
What?
Okay. So let's put it to the test. Ideal for your mail.
Well, ideal, okay. Oh my gosh, so your mail.
You may have to fold your mail in half. Well, you may have to fold your mail in half and
Are
cut it
kidding?
Off a little. Okay. Let's see. How about this? No. All right. So you take your mail. You fold your mail into four. Your mail fit. Look at that. Look at that. And handy
the,
for
they
it
must
says
have the
great
tiniest
for plants.
Plant.
Little plant up here. And let's see.
Oh my
gosh. A little mug. I can't even get my mug. It's too far away.
Wouldn't have fit on top
and
anyway.
And then we can put stuff in the drawer. No.
That doesn't even look like it's centered. That
anyway,
handle.
It's not.
Look, the place is like totally organized all at once. So this is really fun. Back in the days before it was easy for them to just hack your account, this was, and I had a whole lecture about mail order ripoff. What companies would do would sell stuff with no sense of scale.
There's a plenty of sense of scale.
Like
there's a plant
is it,
on it.
Game that I run
yes,
on
right, gizwiz.biz. Right.
You had no idea what you were getting. And you were really surprised when a tiny little box came. So Country Store Organizer, I'm sorry to say, it's not available. And I'm not selling mine because it's too many laughs. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I wonder if Charlie would fit up here.
Oh my gosh. That's
a riot, isn't it?
A riot. What a riot.
Well, they were so you're too young to know,
what
but they
was,
were
what
so
what was that coffee cup on top? I mean, that must have been a thimble.
It must have been doll furniture. They
oh
must have gotten miniatures somewhere to get a plant and a coffee cup. No, it was a riot. I used to do this all the time on Regis of items that in the picture looked amazing. And when you got them, you couldn't believe the size of the box. When the box came, you thought, I'm in trouble now. But the thing is, they kept it cheap enough that
you wouldn't complain. You want it back? Okay, it's $7 shipping to get it back.
Exactly. And that's what they normally would do, is like charge you $6 for the item, $7 for shipping. And in the copy would say, we'll refund your money, but not your shipping. So, you know, by the time you ship it back, all you're going to do is get $3. You might as well just have a laugh with it and say, I got taken, but never again.
Oh, my God. How did you even find these?
You know what they were? They were in the back of magazines.
So you just buy them all?
I bought everything. And often the Sunday newspaper, in among the ads, you know, they drop in those color ads. Often their one page was one of these items. And it was just every once in a while I would get something that was good and I would go, oh, no, I can't use this on television.
This is worthless. What am I going to do with this how dare they actually advertise what this really is?
Wait a minute. This is worth $7. What are they, crazy?
Exactly. Oh, man. Anyway. That is too funny. That is very, very funny.
I have more of them. So in a couple months, I'll do another one.
Wow. Okay. Wow. I did not expect that that good of a nugget to come out of the warehouse. That is fantastic. Okay. Well,
and the wording is so early American replicas, you know, and a wood finish. It's like a wood finish on a piece of cardboard.
Yeah. And the thing wasn't even centered.
I know. Yeah. It's just fun. Anyway.
Wow. Right. Okay.
Okay.
Well, let's jump into the letter.
Here come the letters, the lovely letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters.
I like what Myra has to say. People were very tiny back then. You know, people have grown over the years. Vitamins. Sorry, go ahead.
You know what? We were just dancing to the theme, I have one irate letter, and it is where. This is not the letter of the week. This is a bonus letter.
Right.
The letter is Chad.
Uh-oh.
And Dick.
Uh-oh.
Where is the Christmas theme?
Ooh.
We should be playing the Christmas theme all summer. Do we have it?
I'm sure we have it. Let's see if I can find the Christmas. We should play it all summer, and then when we get to Christmas, we should play the Halloween theme, definitely.
The joke at Mad was we had a Christmas tree up January to November and took it down in December.
Okay, here we go. Let's.
You found it?
I think I do. Here we go. We got. I need to find Monday, Tuesday. No, I don't think I have it. I think that says Santana.
Oh yeah, no, that's not it.
No, that's not it. Yeah, I have Elvis, Beatles, Santana, disco, punk, Michael Jackson. Then I have Sings 1.1, 60s. Bling, chant, and then I have the Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
No, we have to find the Christmas theme. We'll get Beatmaster on this.
Right,
he finds everything.
Yeah. Can you find me the eBay listing of the Christmas theme, please?
Yes, exactly.
That'd be great, Beatmaster.
Exactly. All right, so on to the letter then. The letter of the week is from Douglas Ferguson, and the subject is, here's a what the heck is it gadget for you. Dick and Chad, a friend of mine demolishes buildings. He runs across strange things. He found this item, and in 2+ years, nobody has ever been able to identify what this is. Do you have any ideas? The metal piece is hollow. The wood piece is solid.
Wow. It's completely solid. It's not like it first appears like it looks like a train whistle.
You know what? It's so funny. I was thinking, is it a part of an organ? Now the problem here is the what the heck is it game, you are seeing the entire item.
We may only have seen a part.
This may be part of something. I thought it was going to be the top of an organ pipe, because you're right. That wood piece near the top looks like it's notched.
Notched for a
sound,
yeah.
Right?
But yeah, if you look down here, the bottom of this is totally wood, and he said it was solid.
It's
not hollow. The wood is not hollow.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I think that is just... Right now.
Now, everybody's saying pipe from a pipe organ. That's what I thought. A duck call? Oh, a duck? No, it couldn't be.
No, yeah, I don't think it's anything musical because of the fact that this wooden part is...
Yeah.
An early squirt gun for tubes of chalk or glue. It's a solid piece, and it fits all... It looks like it fits most of the way down. I can't tell if it slides all the way down or not.
Oh, I see, I see. So they're saying you might put something in there...
And then
and use the wood as the plunger.
A horse medicine giver, says John Hatton.
Yeah, John Hatton, right.
It does. It looks like the top of a Lincoln log up here.
Yeah, it does. A plunger of some sort. A vent stopper for a steam radiator. Boy, the chat room's pretty good. I think they're all dead wrong, but they're pretty good.
Yeah. No, these are great wrong answers, definitely.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Well, if anybody comes up with it with a photograph that proves what it is,
right.
I'll send you a Mad Magazine and an Alfred E. Newman picture. And also, we forgot to mention.
Oh, yeah, we did.
We forgot to mention that you can win an Alfred E. Newman picture and a Mad Magazine if you will send us a video, okay? A gadget that you own, a weird gadget. It can be a weird gadget, but you have to know what it is, okay? We're gonna throw that in. So we need more viewer videos, something you have around, even if it doesn't work, but, you know, it's old and you love to tell us about it, or something that you bought and it was awful, or any interesting item that you come across. We would like to just make a 2 to 3 minute video, put it on YouTube. You can click unlisted and then send us the link. That way people won't stumble upon it and see it if you don't want that to happen. Just send us the link and we'll show it on Giz Wiz. And if we do, you get a Mad Magazine and an Alfred E. Newman picture. If you know what that thing is and you can prove it, you'll also get a Mad Magazine and the December issue of Mad. You'll get a picture of Alfred E. Newman and December Mad.
Okay. I'm searching right now for horse medicine dispensers.
Oh, that's funny.
Because a few people were saying, but I think nowadays it's all plastic and latex, not copper and wood.
Maybe so. It was an early car vacuum.
I think you're on to something there, Dick.
Yeah.
I think you are. Interesting letter from Douglas. Thank you so much, and send over your suggestions. With that, I want to give a big thank you to our patrons over at patreon.com. They make this show happen every single week. For your donations, thank you so, 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 so much. Patreon.com is a place where you can support independent content creators like ourselves. Our page is patreon.com/gizwiz, and that's where you can support the show. And we greatly appreciate all of the generosity that our supporters have given us so far. Thank you guys so much. If you want to see descriptions of all of the gadgets that we talked about on today's episode, head on over to gizwiz.biz. We're going to find out what the heck is it next week, right?
Yes, we will.
Exciting, exciting. So this is the very last moment to get your guesses in on the official What the Heck Is It at gizwiz.biz. Just scroll down and click on the What the Heck Is It banner and make a guess. And I swear I have seen this somewhere before, but I don't exactly know what this is for. I can tell that it's some home improvement something or another. So I'm going to guess... it is a way to keep paint from falling onto your hand. It's a paintbrush handle clamp. It's my actual guess right before we go into figuring out what it is for next week. But I don't know. I could be wrong. So get your guesses over at gizwiz.biz. There's 12 Mad Magazines signed by Dick himself for correct answers, but 24 double the Mad Magazines for funny, hilarious, clever, and interesting answers. Keep them short and send them on over to the email on that page. That's 36 Mad Magazines up for grabs, folks. So get a guessin' at gizwiz.biz. You can catch this show live about about at 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern every Thursday.
Actually, we've been very good.
We've been pretty good.
Pretty good. Maybe 10 minutes most.
Exactly.
Ever late.
Yep. Exactly. The place to check us out live, gizwiz.tv. That's our website. It has all of our show notes. It has the places for you to subscribe. And then there's the live video and the chat room right before we go live. That all updates, and the website handles all that, which is quite nice. You can also check out the show notes with links to where you can find the gadgets that we talked about, and also links to the articles that Dick wrote up on gizwiz.biz, and you just click the name to go to Dick's articles, and then click the link to go to the product. Big thanks to Josh for keeping that all up to date.
Yes, thank you, Josh.
He's the one who does all of that. That about wraps it up for this episode of the Giz Wiz. We will see you next week.
And I'll be here.